story of a single boy on a lifeboat and living with his tiger.
The most important thing is the relationship with the tiger. So the tiger has a lot of meanings to him. It can be a representative of nature.
Pai and Richard Parker really connect because they're alone and they have to survive, so they need each other.
Patience!
You're not gonna have a tiger to do this and that with a boy. Only ocean. You can't film for real. Now, how do you make that happen?
Life of Pi is definitely one of the most challenging projects I ever worked on. Knowing that we were gonna have to intercut between a real tiger and the digital one, it hasn't been done in the past.
You have to learn from the real thing.
We got hundreds of hours of reference footage, studying the way the paw rolls off the floor when he walks, the way little sections of his body jiggle, and those little things make them look like animals. A tiger is like a bundle of muscles surrounded by a loose bag of skin. So our skin simulations have to handle all those little details, folding the right way. We had over 15 artists just working on the fur. Someone has to comb and place all the 10 million hairs that are on his body. We have people in Los Angeles, people in India, some other artists in Vancouver and Kuala Lumpur all working on Richard Parker. It required the advancement of technology, it required computers to get fast enough to match it in 3D.
I was fighting sometimes air and sometimes somebody holding the spear.
By bringing the real animal, you set a standard for the CGI companies. This is what you have to match.
If you didn't have Richard Parker, in a sense, would be freer. He would have access to the entirety of the lifeboat, but he'd also be completely alone. And so it gives something for Pi to do. It gives him meaning in his life.
Come on!